Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about dynamic pages. Dynamic pages is a feature available on Wix.com to simplify your site and reduce the amount of pages. Let's say that you have a site with 100 pages and 50 of those pages follow the same structure, changing only the content. In this case, you can use a dynamic page to simplify it and reduce the amount of pages on your site. Okay, let me show you exactly what I'm talking about. First of all, I created this website. As you can see, I created 5 pages and I named them as Home, Dogs, Cats, Turtles, and Ducks. Now, I'm going to show you what I have on them. The first one is the dogs. As you can see, it has 2 photos, title and description. The second one is the cats, and it also follows the same structure, 2 photos, title, and a paragraph. Then the turtles and the ducks following exactly the same structure. So what if I could have only one page that would personalize itself for what I want to see? First, we need to enable the core view. It will allow us to work around our database. It is located on the top of your screen inside the tab called Dev Mode. Once you hit Enable Core View, a screen will appear. You can close it. You will also notice that a new tab will appear on the left of your screen. But we don't need this tab now. You can close it by hitting the arrow left at the bottom of the screen. Something else was added to the editor. Now, also we have the data icon located on the left side of your screen. Through this icon, we'll be able to manage our content that will be displayed on our dynamic page. Each of those pages created to add photos, titles, and descriptions of the animals will be stored inside the database. And I'm going to show you now how to do it. Let's click on the data icon and create a new collection. When you click create new collection, a new pop-up gonna show up. On the left side, you have the option use a present. On the right, you have the option start from scratch. Let's choose this one. In the next screen, you have to name your database. For this example, we are going to use animals. Below it, you have a question. What is this database collection for? We are going to choose site content. In this space, we will tell the database how we are adding data to the collection and how we are going to use it. Let's keep it simple for now. Click on Create Collection. After that, the collection will be created and you are going to see this screen. On the left, you have Sandbox and Live. Sandbox is the database we work while using the editor. The Live is the one available for your published site. On the right, you are able to import and export data, define permission, and sync data between the Sandbox and Live. This is very important. The data you input on your Sandbox and Live will only reflect on each other if you use the option Sync. We are going to change the fields. The first one is Title. Let's change it for Animal Name, and below the name we have the field Type. Let's keep it as Text, as we are going to input text on it. Let's create a new field, just click on the plus sign in front of the previous field, and then let's name it description. Right, let's also keep text as the field type. Again, let's create a new field and call it image1, as we're gonna have 2 images. Another field now called image2. Okay, now we have to pay attention to one detail. What type of a field are you using for all those fields? First one, it's only text, we add a text. That's fine. Okay, let's check the second one, description. Description, we're gonna add only text as well. So should be text there. Let's have a look. Great, text. Now let's check images. Oh, we have text and we're gonna add image to it. Just let's change it for image and save it. And let's repeat the same thing for image 2. Choose image, and that's it. We have four animals. First thing we're gonna do is add four lines. Then we're gonna start to add data into it. The first one we're gonna call dogs and add a description. After that, let's choose the image. Now that we have the image that we want, let's go for image 2 and do exactly the same thing. Great, now we chose the second image and then we have the first line. I'm gonna finish all of them. Now that I entered all the four animals that we have on our website, I'm gonna pay attention to a message that I have on my left top corner of my screen. And this screen is saying that all my data on Sandbox is only available for the preview mode. If I want to see it on my live site, I would have to go to my live database. As you can see, the live database is still empty. So let's sync the information between them. On your right corner, just click in sync. The first option says copy all items from the Sandbox to the live site. And this is the option we're going to choose for now. If you were using your database to collect data from your users online, you would have to choose the opposite side, replace all items from live to Sandbox, but it's not the case now, let's keep it simple. If you check now on your live database, you see that's still empty. It will only show after publishing the site. Now, let's go back to the editor and click on the first link on your left of your monitor that says Menus and Page. You're gonna see the option Dynamic Page. If you haven't used Dynamic Page before, this page will be empty, as you can see. What you have to do is add to site. You will see a quick explanation about dynamic pages. You just need to click start creating. Now you have item page and category page as options. Item page is if you want only one line of your data being displayed in that page. If you want multiple data being displayed in one page, you can use category page. In this case, we just want to show one line for the dogs or cat. Let's use item page. On the top, you have which database do you want to use. As we only have animals, let's just click animals. If you had multiples, just choose the one. In this space, we're going to define the URL for your dynamic page. Let's just use animals, that's the name of the database we're using, and animal name to make a filter for that database. And click in the next one, create page. This page will be created, and now we have in the middle of the screen an item called dataset. Dataset is a connection that you have with items from that page to your database. If you go to the settings of that dataset, you'll be able to see to which collection is this dataset collected to, and the name of it. The mode that is read only in this case, because we just want the user to be able to see what we are displaying, and the number of items to display. The dataset item is invisible. You can add it to any part of your screen. Now, let's go back to the dogs page and copy the same structure that was used in there for our dynamic page. We can use exactly the same structure, title, two photos, and the description. Once you paste it on your dynamic page, you can see that we have two photos, a title, and description. What we're gonna do is click first on the title, and then you're gonna have the options on the top of it. If you notice, the last option is connect to data. Let's choose this option. Once you click connect to data, this is the screen you see. At the top, you have the name of the dataset it's connected. Right below is text connected to. Let's choose the text that we want to display there. In this case, this is a title, so let's choose animal name as a title. Let's repeat everything for the other elements. The next one is a description. Click on it, connect to data, and choose which data it will be connected to. In this case, description, as we had before. Now, let's do exactly the same thing for the two photos that we have. The first one, let's call it images. Now we need to choose images. Remember, we are storing an image in another text. So you just need to click image 1. And now we're gonna do it for the image 2. Again, click in connect to data and choose image 2. That's it. Now that we have connected
all the elements from our dynamic page to one specific section of our database, let's preview it and see how it looks like. As you can see, when you click in preview, we're going to see the cuts first. Wix gives you the option to have this small tab on your right corner on the top, so you can change it while in preview mode. And then you can see every time you change, all the content change. The structure is the same, but the content is different. All of it using only one table. As you can see, Turtle was cut off. You make sure you edit it so you can fit all the words that will be available for that element. Okay, if you make it too small, the element might not display perfectly, but in this case, you can see that it's fixed. Now, let's go back to our editor and publish our site. Now that your database and dynamic page is ready to go, let's try it now. On your live site, let's go to the dynamic page. But there is a problem. We did not connect anything to our dynamic page. So let's use the photos that we have and connect them to our dynamic pages, because we still work with dogs and cats. But if you click on the image that you have on the first screen, they just show up, they don't connect to anything. So let's connect those photos to our dynamic pages. Now let's go back to the editor, click on the photo you wanted to edit, and click in Manage Media. Now choose one of the photos that you wanted to set up first. Let's start for the dog. Click on Links, and when link opened, on the left you're going to have the option to open a new page when that photo is clicked. On your right you have what page it's going to. So in this case, let's choose Animals. When you choose Animals, they're going to ask you which animal do you want to display when you click in that photo. Let's choose Dogs, and just press Done. Remember to give a name to your photo. It is always important for your SEO. And then you click Done. I have added the link to all the photos. Let's try it now on our live site. Now, when you click on the photo of the dog, let's see what happens. Okay, it gets bigger, and you have a link on your right that actually works as your dynamic page, but you still have a lot of work around it. By default, some galleries could come with the settings, but let's change it back to the editor. You have to click on the gallery you want to change. You just need to click on it and choose the option Settings. Inside Settings, you're going to have another option called Settings. And the first option is how the photo will behave once you click it. Let's just choose the option A Link Opens, as we have a link already connected to each photo. Let's now publish and check the live site. Let's click first on the dog photo, and there you go, you have the dog. Back to the homepage, we have the cat. Let's click on it. There you go, we have the same structure, different content, only one page. Now, all we have to do is to go back to the editor and delete all those extra pages that we had. And keep in mind that if you have different structures, you can just create another dynamic page and connect different content to it, and you have something different. Play around, and I hope you enjoyed this lesson.